indices and standard form. Subject mathematics. Class is PC. This is lesson number 2 for week number 2, 13th April to 17th April 2020. Resources. Day 3 book, 7th edition by Dr. Joseph Yu. Its chapter number 4 is included. We are discussing here. Page number 85 to 97. We have also following links to help in this regard. Methodology. Audio aids, visual aids, educational video, and homework assignments. Objectives. By the end of the lesson, the students will be able to evaluate numbers with zero indices, evaluate numbers with negative indices, and evaluate fractional numbers with negative indices. Topic. The main topic is indices and standard form. This is from chapter number 4. Subtopics. Zero indices, negative indices, and rational indices. Brainstorming. We recall the previous lesson number 1 taught during last week just to revise the main basic concepts for the continuity of the lesson. Yes, boys, we have simple questions just to revise some main ideas. Yes, boys, first question is, how many laws of indices we have studied? Answer is very simple. We have studied 5 laws of indices. Yes. Next question. What is the rule for multiplication of the same bases? Again, answer is, in case of multiplication of same bases, we simply add up their powers to get a single base with a single power. Zero indices. This rule states that a power 0 is equal to 1. It means, in any case, whenever we have some number, some variable with whole power 0, we get answer 1. For example, evaluate each of the following. 12 power 0 in part A, 12 power 0. This is directly we get answer. 12 power 0 is 1. Similarly, B, x power 0, solution, x power 0 is again equal to 1. In C part, 4, y power 0, anything with power 0 is 1. So we write y power 0 as 1. In next step, solution, 4 y 0 equals 4 into 1, that is 4. In D part, 12 x cube whole power 0, again we have discussed already, anything whole power with whole power 0 is equal to 1, so we directly write 12 x cube whole power 0 is equal to 1. Negative indices. If a is a real number, then a power minus m equals 1 over a power n. It means we can change any negative index if we take this number from numerator to denominator or from denominator to numerator. For example, evaluate 3 power minus 2. We cannot evaluate some negative index directly. First, we should write this index as positive index. For example, here 3 power minus 2 can be written as 1 over 3 power 2, changing sign of the power, that is 1 over 9. In part B, 5x power minus 4. Minus 4 is the index only with power x. So we can change this index into positive as 5 over x power 4. Then in part C, we have 2 over 3 with whole power minus 2. We take reciprocal of this fraction, getting 3 over 2 with whole power plus 2. By taking reciprocal, we change the sign of the index. Now 3 over 2 whole square is equal to 9 over 4. Rational indices. If n is a positive integer, then we define x whole power 1 over n equals nth root of x. If m and n are positive integers, then a power m over n can be written as nth root of x power m. Example, write 7th root of x in index notation. We can write 7th root of x equals x whole power 1 over 7. Keep in mind here radical is 7 outside the radical sign written. We simply write 7 as 1 over 7 in index form. So getting answer 7th root of x equals to x power 7.